as thou hast been, thou forever will be. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest.
Good morning, y'all. Come on in. Good morning over on Facebook. Good morning, Miss Gwendolyn. Now come on in, invite your followers, let them know that we are on. Share with your friends and your family. We are on Facebook as well as YouTube. The YouTube page is Lakeisha Galladay. So y'all jump over there. You can send people over there if they don't have Facebook. So we have YouTube and Facebook. Come on in. Hey, Kim Moody, how are you this morning?
Great is thy faithfulness. Morning, my morning, no mercies I see.
We give people some time to come on.
Yes, great is thy faithfulness. Oh, great is thy faithfulness.
Facebook went down, so let's try it again. Let me make sure I'm on the Wi-Fi. Yeah. Give them a moment to come on in. Y'all come on back in.
Introducing
me. Live fail the last time.
Inspired by real women's beauty rituals. Combining fragrances inspired by nature. With 1/4 moisturizers and 48-hour protection. Discover new Dove nourishing secrets.
Good morning, Miss Melissa. Good morning. Y'all go ahead and invite and let the people know that Girlfriend's Prayer Circle is on. Hey, Kim Moody, my other one went down. Thank you for coming back.
Like the sun up in the sky, Jesus, you're the light. Oh, how I need you. I met a diamond so perfect. I had some dreams come true. But all of this ain't worth it. If I had to live.
Hey Chantel, good morning. Good morning. Y'all come on in. I'm gonna give just a few more seconds and then we're gonna go ahead and get started. It is 6:47. I wanted to be started by 6:45, but my other one went down, so we're gonna give just a second for the people to come on. Y'all come on in. We're gonna have a time of devotion and prayer on this morning. So y'all come on in. Turn this down just a little. Good morning. We're going to get started in just a moment. Y'all do me a favor and share. Let the people know that we are on. Our devotion is going to come from Psalms 77, and then we'll touch on 78. Y'all come on in. Good morning, Zanae. I see you over on YouTube. Good morning. Good morning, Miss Jada May.
Give them a moment to come on in. Y'all come on back in.
I don't know. My Facebook keep going down.
Live fail the last time.
I don't know what's going on with that. Let me kind of clear some of my stuff on my background real quick. So now we're going to go ahead and get started. I don't know what's going on with my Facebook this morning. It keeps going down. All right, we're going to just jump right into it. Yes, this is YouTube. But you might want to stay over on YouTube because my Facebook keep going down. Give them just a few seconds and then we're just going to jump right into it because I don't know what's going on over on Facebook. Is it clear over on YouTube, Zanae? How is it on YouTube for you? Hey, Miss Melissa, I don't know what's going on this morning. What is it like over here on YouTube, Zanae? Let me know. We're going to just jump right on in. I'm going to go ahead and introduce myself and do all of that. And then hopefully by the time we get ready to jump into our worship. Okay. Hopefully everyone will be back on. Good morning, Miss Shimona. I love you. Okay, gotcha, Zanae. Okay, so we're good. So if I go out on Facebook, if I go out again, because this is my third time trying on Facebook. If I go out on Facebook, go to YouTube. On YouTube, my page is just simply Lakeisha Galladay. So if I go out again on Facebook, jump over to YouTube and just search my name and you should be able to watch there because I got somebody on YouTube watching. So let's jump right into it. Good morning. Thank you all for jumping in and joining and jumping back in because we keep going down on Facebook. But I am Minister Lakeisha Galladay. This is Girlfriends Prayer Circle. Girlfriends Prayer Circle was birthed out of five friends praying together and the Lord told me to open it up. So that is where Girlfriends Prayer Circle was birthed from. I also have The Reach, which is a virtual Bible study where we reach to reveal, expose, and teach people how to approach Christ's heart through the gospel of Jesus Christ. I have not been doing The Reach at this time, but we will be back. I will let you all know I'm kind of moving back into stuff slowly, but I appreciate you all joining me on this morning. So let's jump into this. What we do for Girlfriends Prayer Circle is we do a time of worship. We worship the Lord with our words. We invite him into our virtual gathering. We invite him into our hearts. We invite him into our situation. And then we do a time of devotion and then we pray. If you have a prayer request, feel free to put your prayer request on the screen. And we will lift your prayer request up to the heavens. We'll lift them up on your behalf. We are going to go ahead and get started. I always like to let you know I'm from under the leadership of Pastor Alate Russ at Guildfield Baptist Church. He is now Dr. Russ. I don't know if we're calling him Dr. Pastor, Pastor Doctor, or just Doctor. I don't know what we're calling him. So I'm going to just hit him with all of them. But he is now Dr. Russ. And so we're super proud of him and his accomplishments. We're located at 5170 Guildfield Church Road, Clarksville, Tennessee, 37043. We'd love for you to be my guest. The doors of the church are open. We worship at 11 a.m. On Sunday mornings. And then we also have a 9 o'clock service on the first Sunday. So one Sunday out of the month, we have a 9 a.m. service and the 11. But we are always there at 11 a.m. So let us jump into this and let's make good use of our time. I don't want to hold you too long. Okay, Zanae, I will definitely be praying for Miss Audrey's mother. Yes, we definitely will. Let us go ahead and just begin to worship, and then we're going to move into our devotion. Our devotion is going to come from Psalm 77, and I'm going to also touch on Psalm 78. So let us just begin to worship the Lord. The Lord is good. He is mighty. He is kind. He is faithful. He is our creator and our sustainer. He is the one that keeps us. He keeps us through the storm. He keeps us in the good. He keeps us in the bad. He is the one that keeps our soul, keeps our hearts. He keeps our minds. He is the keeper. He is our keeper and our sustainer, and we bless his holy name. He is righteous. He is holy. He is holy. We serve a holy and a righteous God. We serve a God that is our redeemer. He is the one that redeems us. He saved us. He is the one that delivers. He is the one that pulls us out. He is a strong tower. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run in and they are saved. We thank you, Lord God, that we can run into your name in the time of a storm, God. We can run to you, God, in the time, God, that the enemy is on our track. We can run to you, God, in the times, God, of uncertainty, God. We can run to you, God. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run in and they are safe. I thank you, Lord God, that we are made righteous, God, through your son, Jesus Christ. We are made righteous through your son, Jesus Christ. It's nothing that we can do within ourselves and on our own, but God, we are made righteous through your son. So God, we thank you for your son, Jesus. We thank you for your son, the one that you so love, God. We thank you for your only begotten son, God. But we thank you, God, that you love us so much that you sent your only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall have everlasting life. They will not perish. So God, I thank you for your son that died for me. I thank you for your son that died for Zanae. I thank you for your son that died for Shimona. I thank you for your son that died for Kim Moody. I thank you for your son that died for Miss Melissa. I thank you for your son, Jesus. I thank you for your son that died on the cross, God, that we could have everlasting life, God. I thank you that it's through your son, Jesus Christ, God, that we can have healing, God, his blood. It's his blood that he shed for us while on Calvary. And we thank you, Lord, for the blood. We thank you for the blood that heals, that saves, that delivers, that sets free. We thank you for the blood. We thank you for the blood that is that even on today, it still works, God. So we thank you, Lord, that your blood, God, is touching Miss Audrey's mother right where she is, God. We thank you, Lord, God, for the blood that never loses its power, God. It still works. The blood still works to deliver. The blood still works to heal. The blood still works to save. The Lord is mighty to save, and the Lord is mighty to deliver. He can do it. There is nothing that he cannot do. There is not a thing that exists that God cannot handle. And I thank you, Lord God, that you can handle our broken hearts. You can handle our wayward children. You can handle our wayward ways. You can handle, God, there is nothing that exists that you cannot handle, God. You restore broken relationships. You restore, God, our hearts, God. You restore, God, the losses of finances. You restore, God, and you are the redeemer of time. There is not a thing that God cannot handle. So, God, we say thank you. God, we say thank you, God, that you, God, can handle it. We say thank you, Lord God, that you can handle it, God. We thank you, Lord God, that you are a God that still performs miracle signs and wonders. We thank you, Lord God, that you are a God of miracles. You are a God of miracles. We thank you, God, that you are a God of miracles. And we thank you, Lord God, that God, you performed miracles back in the Bible days, God, that we read about, God, but you are still performing miracles, signs, and wonders even today, God. So we thank you, Lord God, that we will see miracles manifest, God, right before our eyes, God. We thank you, God. We give you glory. We give you honor in Jesus' name. We bless you, God. You are a miracle worker. You are a God of miracles. You are the God that makes ways, God. We say thank you, God, and we bless you. We say thank you, God, and we bless you. Psalm 77, and I'm just really, our devotion is coming from a place of my prayer time. I was praying for someone yesterday, and I just began to declare that God will perform a miracle in and through their life. Good morning, Miss K over on YouTube. I begin to declare that God would perform a miracle in their life, and I believe that even on today, there are some up under the sound of my voice that need God to perform a miracle in their life. You need God to move mightily in a situation. You need God to move mightily in your life. You need God to perform a miracle in your life. What is a miracle? What is a miracle? My definition, in my words, a miracle is anything, is something that is done out of the norm that only God can do. There are things that with man it is impossible, but we know that with God all things are possible. So a miracle, this is just my words of what a miracle is. A miracle is anything done out of the norm that can only be done in and through Christ, in and through God. So a lot of us are standing in the need of a miracle. We need God to work in our lives. We need God to move in some situations. We need God to move in some people's bodies to heal. I believe that God is still able to perform miracles even today. And not only is he able, I believe that he will perform miracles even today. Good morning, Miss Audrey over on YouTube. I believe that he will perform miracles. We're going to see miracles manifest. Why do we see miracles manifest? A lot of the miracles, and I did a teaching on miracles through the Reach some time ago. What were the reasons that Jesus performed miracles? The miracles is for the non-believer. The miracle is to bring glory unto God. The miracle is so that the non-believer and the unsaved can, their faith can be built up and they can be saved. They can believe. They can have faith to believe that if God can do it for this one, he can do it for that one. And you know what? It's even a miracle that when we are saved. It's even a miracle when we receive our salvation. God is a God of miracles. And I just begin, as I was praying for this individual, I just begin to think about the miracles that God had performed in the Bible. But then I remembered the greatest miracle of all, when God raised Jesus from the dead. And if God can raise Jesus from the dead, there is nothing that he cannot do on today. The situation that the situation that I was praying for, at first I was gripped with fear. I was gripped with fear, but immediately I began to meditate, and I began to think of the goodness of God, and I began to think of the God that I serve. I was gripped with fear because the person that I was praying for is going through the exact same situation that my mother went through. But I believe that God is a God of miracles. And I believe that he is able, and I believe that he will move in this person's life. I believe that God can perform a miracle. I don't care how bad it gets or how bad it looks. God can still perform miracles. And he can perform a miracle in this individual's life. I don't care if you are on dialysis. I don't care if your kidneys are shutting down. I don't care if your lungs are beginning to not function. God, that's a good place for God to perform a miracle. That is a good place for God to perform a miracle. There is no miracle if there is no problem. There's no miracle if there's not a problem. God needs a situation in order to work in. So let's look at the scripture. And I just began, this is just, and like I said, I'm just sharing devotion today from a place of my prayer. But I was praying from Psalm 77, and I started at verse 13, and it says, "Oh God, your ways are holy. Is there any God as mighty as you?" First thing we got to understand is that we serve a holy God. We serve a God that is like none other. There's no God that is like him, but his ways are holy. And that's why we have to make sure that we take the time to get to know our God's character, get to know who he is. We serve a holy God. And I'm at verse 13, Psalm 77:13. We serve a God that is holy. We serve a God that is holy. We serve a God that is perfect. We serve a God that is perfect in all of his ways. He is holy. He is perfect. And he never fails. But it says, oh God, your ways are holy. Is there any God as mighty as you? And it says, is there any God, little g God, as mighty as you? There is none other that is mighty as our God, Jehovah God, Yahweh. There is none other that is mighty as him. So whatever you do, make sure that you put your faith and your trust in the one that is mighty. Make sure that you put your faith and your trust in the one that can move in your situation. Make sure that you put your faith and your trust in the one that can deliver, in the one that can save, in the one that can perform the miracle in your life. What is his characteristics? He is the miracle worker. He's the way maker. He is love. He is the one that delivers. You got to know the God that you serve. And that comes out of, that's it, Chantel. It comes out of relationship. It comes out of relationship. And like I said, when I first got the news of this individual's situation, the flesh in me was like, oh my God, I've heard this before. I have lived in this before. I have walked through this before. And immediately the spirit said, is there anything too hard for God? And I just began to believe God to perform a miracle in this person's life. Sometimes we got to step outside of our, well, not sometimes, but we have to learn to step outside of our flesh and stay in the spirit. We got to learn how to step outside of our flesh. Don't allow our flesh to overtake us, because in our flesh, fear can touch. In our flesh, fear will try to grip and overtake us. So you got to make sure that you stay in the spirit and you see beyond what you see. See beyond what you see. We serve a God that nothing is too hard for him. And then it goes on to say, is there any God as mighty as you? This is where I want to be in verse 14, Psalm 77, 14. It says, you are the God of great wonders. Y'all, he is the God of wonders. What's another word for wonders? Miracles. He is the God of miracles. It doesn't just say wonders, but it says great wonders. God performs great wonders. He performs great miracles. He does great things. Mighty are the works of his hands. You are the God of great wonders. You demonstrate your awesome power among the nations. So I just begin to tell God, God, demonstrate your great power. Demonstrate your power among the people. Demonstrate your power among the nations. Demonstrate your power in the world. Demonstrate who you are. You are a powerful God. You are a mighty God. You are the God of great wonders. Great miracles. He is the God of miracles. By your strong arm, you redeemed your people, the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. The descendants of Jacob and Joseph, that means that includes everybody. He redeemed your people, the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. He redeemed me. He redeemed you. He redeemed the one that we're believing God to perform a miracle for. What does the word redeem mean? When you think about the word redeem, it means that you were paid for with a price, but it also means that you was to be redeemed, raised up from the dead. God, we need you to do a miracle in some things that seem to be dead. We need you to do and perform some miracles in some things that is dead. Some dead relationships. God, redeem those relationships. Some dead finances. Redeem those finances. Some dead relationships, situations. God, some people have been pronounced dead, but God says that I'm going to raise them up. I am going to redeem them that they may have life and have life more abundantly. God is the God that does great wonders. God, and I bless your name. He does great wonders. And I'm so glad that this promise, that in the word, when you look at the word, it does not leave us out. Sometimes we get so caught up on reading the word and we want to look at it like, oh, this was done back then. But it clearly covers us. It says, by your strong arm, you redeemed your people. Do you belong to him? So he's talking to you. And it says the descendants of Jacob, it goes on to say, and the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. We are the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. That includes everybody. So I thank God that he can redeem that situation in my life. He can redeem that situation in that person's life. He is the redeemer. He is the one that sent his son. He bought us with a price. So we are redeemed. We are saved. We are redeemed. He raises us up from that. Because you got to understand, when we are without Christ, we are spiritually dead. But he is the one that redeems us, raises us up from that dead place. I thank you, God. But not only just from a spiritual death, but those things in our life that seem to be or looks dead, God will raise those things up from the dead. Those relationships, those situations, your finances, when you say, you know what, there's no hope for that person, but God says, I can redeem them too. I can raise them up too. I sent my son that they can be saved. I am the great redeemer. And we bless God. And we bless God. We bless God. We bless God that he will move in our situation. He will move in our situation. He is the God of great wonders. But I want to show you something over in Psalms 78, verse 22. And I'm not going to, for the sake of time, I'm not going to read the whole thing, but I'm just going to kind of tell you. It talks about how the Israelites were mumbling and grumbling, and they did not trust that God could move in their situation. If you go back and read it, it talks about how they said that God was the one that struck the rock and provided water. But he was not going to, but he would not provide food for them. Go back and read it. But I'm just paraphrasing it for you for now. But in Psalm 78, it talks about how the Israelites, they were mumbling and they were grumbling and they were in a place of distrust. And they said, oh, well, he can strike the rock and provide water, but he cannot provide food for us in the wilderness. But God, how many know that God did even that? I need you just to say, God will do even that. That thing that you think is too hard, he can do even that. That thing that we think is out of our reach, it's not out of his reach. That thing that is out of our reach is not out of God's reach. He can do even that too. And it says in verse 22, for they did not believe God or trust him to care for them. And some one version says, because they believed not in God and trusted not in his salvation. Another version says, trusted not in his wonders, trusted not in him to be able to deliver. You got to know that God will do even that. If he provided water from the rock, he can provide food for you in the wilderness. If he made a way out of no way, then he can raise you up from your sick bed. If he did this, he can do that. There is no thing that exists that God cannot do, that God cannot handle. God will do even that. And I bless God that he will do it. He will do that, even that, in your life. He's doing even that in my life. And I thank God that we are seeing the miracles manifest and performed right before our eyes. I love it. I love you, God. I love you, God. I thank God he will do even that. And it says in verse 23, though he commanded the clouds from above and opened the doors of heaven and had rained down manna upon them to eat and had gained them of the corn of heaven, man did eat angels' food. He sent them meat to the full. So they were thinking God gave us water, but he can't give us food. But God did even that. It says it in scripture. We got to be so careful that we don't get so caught up with what we see that we doubt the hand of God. That by what we see, we doubt the power of God. By what we see, we doubt what God can do in and through our lives. By what we see, we doubt what God will do in and through another person's life. I always use my son as an example. I got one son, and people, they want to write him off. They want to say that he's this and he's that. But I say that he is a man of God. I don't see him through the eyes of man. I don't see him, and I don't put a label on him by what people see and by what other people have said. But he is a man of God, because I know that God can move even in that. And he has even said, when he was a little boy, he used to say, I'm going to be a preacher. And I believe that that will manifest. God is going to move in and through his life, and he is going to be a mighty man of God. You gotta believe God for not from what you see, but what you know of God. That's why you gotta know God for yourself. Don't allow what you see to cause you to doubt who God is, or doubt his hand, or doubt his power. We serve a God of great wonders. Let's pray, y'all. We serve a God of great wonders. And God, we are believing you to perform great and mighty wonders in our lives, God. There are many that are on this live, God, and that will watch the replay, and they are waiting on you. They are believing you to move in their lives, and they need you, God, to do some things that cannot be done by man, God. We thank you, God, that you, God, are the God that heals, God. We thank you, Lord, that you are the God that saves. We thank you, God, that you are the God that brings us out. You are the God of breakthrough. You are the God of provision. You are the God of peace. God, perform miracles in and through our lives, God. Perform them in our lives, God. And God, you're going to get the glory, God. And when you perform the miracles in and through our lives, God, I thank you, Lord God, that others will be saved. The miracle is so that God can get the glory. The miracle is so the glory will, the lens will be put on God and his greatness, God and his goodness. God, we bless your name, God. We magnify you. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. God, you are good. You are mighty, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. And God, I pray even now, God, that those, God, that are in a place of doubt and unbelief, God, I'm like the man that brought his son to you. God, help our unbelief. He says, Lord, if you are willing, if you are able, heal my son. And the Lord said, if I'm able, not only am I able, but I am willing and able. And the man said, Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. Sometimes you just got to be honest and say, God, I was a little bit afraid, but God, help my unbelief. God, I was a little bit discouraged, but help my unbelief. God, I doubted just a little bit, but help my unbelief. God, I know that you can do it. God, I know that you can do it. God, and while you're doing it, help me. Help me to believe fully that you can do it. He says, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed. I used to have a pack of mustard seeds, and I don't know what I did with those mustard seeds, but mustard seeds, if you've never seen a mustard seed, a mustard seed is probably about the size of one of these little sparkles on my earring. A mustard seed is the smallest seed, but when you see when it grows great. But if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, then you're good. All you got to do is just have a little bit of faith, and God will move in your life. But God, I want you to build up our faith even now, God. Build our faith up, God. Lord, that we would have great and mighty faith. God, that when we come to you, God, you'll say, I've never seen a faith so great like this. I've never seen faith like this. God, how do we build up our faith? The Bible says that our faith is built up through the word. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. So God, let me just help y'all on this morning. God performs miracles. He is the God that made a way through the Red Sea. When Pharaoh was on the Israelites' track, God opened up the Red Sea and they walked across on dry land, not muddy land, not messy land, but they walked across on dry land. And God, when the enemy tried to go through, they drowned in the Red Sea. He is the God of miracles. God is the God that even when man said no for Hannah, she was barren. Her womb was barren. She went in and she pleaded with God and she believed God and she brought forth a son. He is the God of miracles. When man says no, God can still say yes. And we thank you, Lord God, that you are the God of miracles. You are the God of miracles. When Joseph, when there was a famine in the land, God had positioned Joseph to be able to help his family. When everybody else was hungry, Joseph had enough for his family. They came to him and he was able to provide. That's a miracle. God will set you up for greater. God will set you up to be able to reach back and save somebody else. That's a miracle. God is the God of miracles. He is the God that when there is no way, he opens up a way. He makes a way. He is the God of miracles. But I love the fact that God performed the greatest miracle of all. When his son was hung on the cross, he died and he was buried in a borrowed tomb, and on the third day he rose up with all power in his hand. And it's because of the power that Jesus Christ has that we can believe for a miracle. It's because of the power of Jesus Christ that we can believe God to heal. We can believe God to move in our situations. We can believe God to raise up that sick one. We can believe God to renew. God can give you a new heart. God can give you new lungs. He can give you a new liver. He can give you a new kidney. He can give you a new mind. He'll renew your mind. And we thank God that he is the God that performs great wonders. We thank you, Lord, that you're performing great wonders. He is the God that will heal our hearts. When we're broken, he's the one that will mend our broken hearts. He's the one that will renew our minds. He's the one that restores relationships. He's the one that will raise you from your sick bed. And I thank you, Lord God, that you are performing miracles even now. I lift up Veronica. I lift up Miss Audrey's mother. I lift up Sheila Scott. I lift up those that are under the sound of my voice that know someone that is sick. And even now, my mind is not giving me the names, but there are many out there that are sick. And I thank you, Lord, that you, God, are performing miracles. I thank you, Lord, that you're performing a miracle in Micah Pace's life, God. You're touching, God, and you're doing great and awesome things. And I thank you, Lord, God, that swelling is going down. God, I thank you, Lord, that you're moving in and through her body, God. I thank you, Lord, God. I thank you, Lord, that you're moving in Doris Ruffin's life, God. I thank you, Lord, that a miracle is being performed, God. I thank you, Lord, God. I thank you, God, that you are doing a miracle in Yvonne Johnson's life, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you're doing a miracle in Miss Molly Johnson's life, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you're touching Miss Maddie Atkins, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you, God, are doing great and mighty things. You do great wonders, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you are performing a miracle in Erica Russell's life. Yes, God, we bless you, God. God, you get all the glory from her life, God. She will live to give the testimony. God, I thank you, God, for how you're keeping her, God, even on hard days. Her mind, God, that she would keep her mind stayed on you. You said that if we keep our minds stayed on you, God, You will keep us in perfect peace. God, I thank you, Lord God, that those that are under the sound of my voice, they're going through something and their body is rocking with pain, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you are the God that comforts, God. You are the God that comforts. And let me tell y'all something. I know him to be a comforter. I know him to be a comforter. He's going to be a comforter in your life so that you can come back and be a comforter in somebody else's life. I thank you, Lord God, that God, you, God, are the God that will take the pain away. You will take the pain away, God. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I bless you, God. I thank you, Lord God, that miracles, signs, and wonders, God. You said that miracles, signs, and wonders will follow the word, God. And I thank you that even on today, even as we went through this devotion, God, that miracles, God, we'll get testimonies of miracles. We'll get testimonies of signs and wonders. You are the God of great wonders. You are the God of great wonders, God. And God, we will not doubt you. We will not be in disbelief. We will not be fearful, God, for you have not given us a spirit of fear, but you've given us power, love, and a sound mind. Our mind will be sound. We'll have one mind. We will not be double-minded when it comes to what we are believing you to do in our lives, God. You, God, are the God of great wonders. You, God, are the God that has all power in your hands, God. And we thank you for being a mighty powerful, a mighty good God, a mighty and faithful God. You are mighty, God, mighty and strong, mighty to deliver, mighty to save, mighty to set free, mighty to heal. And God, we bless your name. We bless your name, God. And we thank you that you, God, are doing it even now. That thing, God, that you are doing even that. You are doing even that. The Israelites said, he gave us water out of the rock. He cannot give us food in the wilderness. But you did even that. So I thank you for today that you're doing an even that miracle. God, and I bless you. We'll give you all the glory, all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I thank you, God. I pray that you all were blessed. Listen, I love each and every one of you. And I truly believe that God is moving in your life. He is moving in your situation. Don't doubt God, but trust God. See beyond what you are able to see. When you look at that situation, see God in your situation and know that because God loves you, he'll move in your situation. Because God loves you, when you call, he will answer. And we serve a God that not only hears us, but he comes to us. He answers us. He moves for us. He works for us. And you may not see how God is doing it, but he's doing it. Even when you don't see it, he's working all things for your good. Even when you don't even know, he's working all things for your good. Listen, I love you guys, but God loves you the most. I love each and every one of you. Good morning, Aunt Shirley. I think I had seen Donna on here. There's some that came on as we was in, already in. So good morning to you, Heather. Hey, cousin. How you doing? Leanne. I see many of y'all. Grab a hold of that. God will do even that in your life. There's nothing that exists that God cannot handle. I love you guys. I gotta go. I love you guys. Y'all have an amazing, wonderful day. Be blessed and see God in your situation. Y'all have a good evening. I mean, a good day.